I actually worked on a research project involving using stem cells to create an artificial skin substitute to improve wound healing. With the use of this research, we can actually go ahead and use these artificial skin substitute to treat a lot of wounds, including burns, diabetic ulcers, traumas, etc. So there's a huge implication for what we could do with this research.
So my research project was about epilepsy awareness here in Grenada. The aim or objective of my study was to characterize the level of epilepsy awareness here in Grenada. We wanted to identify any common misconceptions or false beliefs regarding epilepsy that could potentially increase the risk of injury to patients that suffer from seizure disorders. Also, another big part of our research project was education. We wanted to educate the Grenadian population a little bit about epilepsy and what you should and should not do in the event of a seizure.
This led to a project where we're looking for the blood supply of a ligament in the pelvis area, the sacral subarachnoid ligament, and we mapped out all the variations of the vascular structures, and even we had the opportunity of naming a blood vessel in that location as well. The most important implications is if we're doing any surgeries in the back, in the sacrum, or in the gluteal region, the surgeons will have a good map on which areas to avoid in order to prevent a massive bleed or any ligations or closing any arteries in that area.
So my research was actually a meta-analysis of the cerebrospinal fluid of Alzheimer's disease patients. And what we were mainly aiming to do was to look at the hypotheses that are mainly researched at this particular time, and to see why a lot of the therapeutic targets are not necessarily working or failing in clinical trials.